Welcome everyone. My name is Rens van Haren and I work at Mimaki as an application specialist. Today we're going to cover one of my favorite topics, UV printing in combination with laser cutting. With the technology of Mimaki UV LED printers in combination with the super accurate laser cutters, you can make the most diverse products in an instant. These combination of machines are widely used for promotional items like trophies, keychains, signage, but also for industrial products like the automotive industry and also for the industrial plates, signing and control panels. I can already hear you thinking, doesn't the ink break after cutting? No. With our all-round ink, LOS 120, the semi-flexible ink, it's possible to post-processing after printing using cutting, creasing, but also with the laser cutter without the ink break because of the flexibility of this ink. Now it's time to look how this unique process between UV printing and laser cutting come together with this movie. Enjoy watching. In this tutorial, we're going to show you how to create acrylic keychains in three simple steps. The first step will be done in Illustrator for the artwork. The second step we're going to print through our RIP software. And the third and last step will be done in Job Control. And that's a software to cut the acrylics with the Trotec laser. First, we need to create an artboard. And the artboard will be, in this case, the same size as the acrylic sheet, and it's A3 size. Then we import the artwork. I have three designs mirrored and duplicate them so they will fit inside the artboard. If we want to cut them, we need a cutting line. The cutting line is a very thin line of RGB red, so 255 red, in a thickness of the line of a 0.001 point thickness. So the cutter will recognize and also won't cut double lines. I'm going to print on acrylic, so we want to have a white layer on it. And the white layer is exactly where I want to have a white around the artworks. And then we have the Trotec mark. With these marks, the Trotec can recognize the begin and start point for cutting, and also the position will be perfect. There are four little circles of 5 millimeters in diameter, with also small thin hairline of 0.001 point in black, RGB black. So all zero. We're going to save these files. First we save the color file. Color one. Separately we save the white file. And then the last one, the cutting file for the Trotec. So the artwork is ready, and we're now going to the RIP software Rasterlink. We're now ready for the second step, preparing the artwork into our RIP software Rasterlink, and if it's done, we are ready to print it on the UGF 7151. First, we're going to open the files, color, and select also white, choose open. I already mirrored the files. And why did we mirror it? Because we're going to print on plexiglass and I want to keep it visible on the other side of the black plexiglass. You can also do it afterwards by using the function in Rasterlink. Both files are in the queue. Select the one you want to print with white. Go to special plate function. Choose the ink type, white, the density, 90% is more than enough.
created area will be valid pixel because I want to create white on the parts where only color is visible. And just press create. It will automatically create the white layer. The color layer you can delete. Now we want to print color, white, color. So I need to duplicate the color layer. So go to the duplicate tab. Only one is enough, included the RIP data. Press duplicate, and now we have three thumbnails, color, white, color. The last step is combining them. So we select all three of those using the shift button. Go to composition. Choose your sequence, in this case, color, white, color. Press composite. And they're combined, all three of them, in sequence of color, white, color. Setting up the correct resolution and also media. We're going to print on acrylic. Choose a resolution of 600 by 900, 12 bars. And the order will be done in two steps. First color white, table goes back, and then the last color layer will be printed. Go to the execution button and choose rip and print, and we're ready to go. Ready for the final step to cut our acrylic sheet. We placed our acrylic sheet inside of the Trotec laser cutter. We adjusted the height to the correct height and set our laser right on top of the first marker.
We're ready for step three, and we're gonna import the artwork again inside of Illustrator. That's our base program. And because Trotec just works with a common printer driver, it's really to set up your own design software. So I opened the artwork with the marks and the cutting lines. We only need to go to File, Print, and then in the print you see the printer driver is the Trotec engraver. I'm gonna do the setup, preference, and here we can see all details, especially the setups for all kind of materials, the sheet size. So all settings are okay for the Mimaki acrylic 3mm. Say print and print again. Now the file will be uploaded to the job control. So this is job control. The little cross here that you see is the point where the laser is. And as you see before, it's pointed exactly on the marker. On the right side, we have the image. You can click on the little eye, and then like magnetic, the marker will be on the crosshair of the laser cutter. So everything is positioned well. Settings are already done. So we're good to go. Now you know how accurate and easy it is to create these beautiful objects. I want to thank you all for viewing this tutorial. Did you miss something? No problem. Just go to mimakieurope.com. Thank you. Bye bye.